Hi gamers! Welcome to Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic 2, or the Sith Lords, as it's usually called. This is something I've been very excited about for a long time. It's hard to say which one of the two games installments I like the most, because the first one, well, it was my first one. And it had a story that included a huge surprise. So I had never played a game like that before, and it really got me good. But this game, as you can probably hear in the background, the music is darker, it's much darker story too, and it's a very good story. The problem with this game is it was rushed. A lot of great modders have been pulling the lost game files out of the mist, so to speak, and they've created what's known as restored content modification. So that's something I've installed because I want to explore everything I never got a chance to explore. Hopefully it's gonna be bug free, but you never know. So I'm excited to test it out. And I also want to say that I've used a lot of mods this time to try and pretty up the game a bit. So I also installed a mod that I've made, I've modded two mods that I merged together into one, and then I changed it to my liking, the color of her skin and her outfit, because I felt like, yeah, I wanted to make something that I could feel was mine. Well, I think it's time to start up the game. I've already made our new character, so this is just a recording to introduce the game, and then we'll jump in to actually straight into the prologue, which is basically a tutorial. And I did that because I wanted the backstory. You never get it if you don't play the tutorial, and I feel like that's an important part of the story for at least a couple of characters that we'll meet later on. So yeah, that's about it. I'm so excited to start up. It's gonna be a real journey for me, and hopefully for anyone watching. So again, welcome to KoTOR II. We'll be right back.
Ebon Hawk is adrift in space after a terrible battle. Most of its crew are dead or dying. You lie in the medical room in critical condition. You won't survive long without medical attention. The hyperdrive is damaged. Main power must be restored in order to bring the engines online and dock with the nearby Peragus mining station for much-needed repairs. Your fate and that of the Ebon Hawk depend upon T3M4, a lone astromech droid. Return to this location at any time to skip the prologue. Press WASD to move T3M4, then turn. Press caps lock to toggle first person free look. Hold control to look about.
Right, so we... Ebon Hawk looks terrible, and so does T3, poor thing. Hopefully he'll get better in time. So
you have new quests. To view your quests, open the game menu.
Let's do that. So we need to save the Ebon Hawk and heal Shayna. So let's do that.
Escape and look in the journal. This room contains a class field cylinder and the communications console. To target one of these objects.
Let's see. What we got? Slice the systems. Well, we can't. Let's see if we can find a spike somewhere. There's one.
You will come across many containers. Some of which will be locked. The computer
this is the, my favorite improvement of this
such as
game.
Doors.
It says empty now, so I don't have to wonder if I looted or not. So let's see. Now, open the main hole containment door. Sure. Alright, so... Now we can continue. We need to heal Shayna and also ourselves.
This is the main hole.
Yeah.
Your security skill is too low to open this
locker.
However, you can use your weapon to bash it open.
Well,
click on the bash icon or press 1.
Let's do that. It's basically probably gonna ruin some stuff in there, but it's worth a try, right? Yeah, broken item and computer spike.
Sometimes bashing or blowing open a container will break some of the items in the container, but you can use even broken items.
So
can be turned into useful components at a workbench.
Who's that?
This old woman appears to be dead. There is a key card on the body that looks like it opens a locker somewhere.
I just grabbed it. So, what? And blast door. These are new. These chairs. Yeah, that's locked.
Side of the door to this storage.
Security console. Hey.
The door is sealed shut.
No, there's nothing there. Let's... I can slice it? Yes. Security cameras. Right. Let's check. Yeah. We remember this room. Yeah. Looks to be... Can I open something? Open inner garage door or close outer? Alright, let's try that. And open inner. Ah, I see. Well, not gonna help right now, so...
If you need help exploring the Ebon Hawk, access the map screen.
Is this door...
This glass door is magnetic.
It's also... How about this slow security door? Oh,
this
yeah.
This is the cargo hold. Talking to other characters is much like using the computer console.
Oh, yeah, I know.
Note that some responses may influence how other characters react to you, so choose carefully. Furthermore, certain skills...
He's very confused,
3CFD is malfunctioning.
Yeah.
You can fix him by using a part. If you repair 3CFD...
Yep, let's repair it.
Success! You have fixed...
So now, with two droids running around this ship.
3CFD is now a member of your party.
And?
To change which party member you control, click on the portrait or press tab. Later, when you have more...
A pistol? Even? Oh wow.
Sensor droids emerge from this box when you opened it.
Mm-hmm.
These droids will make for excellent target practice. Use the weapon from this container to attack the droids.
Yeah, let's do that.
You can equip a weapon.
So, field survival pistol. So now.
Change your target by pressing B or left on the object you want to target. To attack an enemy or defeating the sensor droids, continue combat training, open the metal box again, and more sensor. The lock on this container is too difficult to open. You'll need to use a security tunneler to help open the lock. Look in the unlocked cylinder next to this one to find security tunnelers.
Right.
If you
so
encounter
now...
a difficult lock on a container or door, you can use a security tunneler on it to improve your chance of opening the lock. Use the security tunneler to
now
open the high security cylinder nearby.
Anything else in here? Don't think so. So, wait. Can I use this on the regular security? Yeah. Alright.
Use the key card.
I got a couple
to open
of
the locker.
Items.
The impact armor.
So, I'm gonna be equipping that. Let's see. Nothing? How about here? Yep. No? Alright, another pistol? No. Nothing for this guy? Nothing at all. He's got a pistol already, so that's cool. But, maybe?
To open the equip screen, click on the blaster icon in the top right area.
You're a bit late. But I don't have any items to heal. No, don't. Nothing for now. Maybe I'll find one later. So now I know what to do. But first, let's see.
This is the engine room.
Yes. All right. So if you stay here. See, you can stay here and then wait. Now we go in solo mode, right? And open the door for what's his name? 3C, right?
This is the main hole.
So, security doors. Now we close this one and open this one. Right. All right. So
this is the garage.
And then we reverse what we just did. Close this one and open this one. All right. So, that's not good. That's not good. Can we repair this?
These sparking wires connect to the trigger mechanism for the inner and outer garage doors.
Oh.
You can open and close the doors from here.
Right, so, let's close this one.
Door closed. Do you want to...
Yes, I want to open
door.
This one.
Do you want to do it?
No. Now I want to go back to T3 and help him out. Wow. My head is not in a good shape. So, can you do the same?
The sparking wire.
Open. No, close.
Door. Do you want?
And open inner.
Door opened.
Right.
Do you want?
So. Now we can probably work together again. Look at this. This is not good. This is not good. Luckily, we're droids and not dependent on air to breathe. So this is probably. Oh, wait a second. I think we might have.
This is the garage.
Locked ourselves out of the area we should have gone to. Yeah, I think so, because we need to find a way.
These sparking wires connect to the trigger mechanism.
Wait a second. So, I don't think we can get. No, we can't. So we need to use the
sparking
ladder, I think.
Door closed. Do you want to do anything else here?
Yes, I want to open the outer door.
Door. Oh, do you want to do?
And now I'm done. So, yeah.
This lift will take you to the outer hull of the Ebon Hawk, mm-hmm. where you will find many parts and mines to use for accessing and repairing the hyperdrive. Use the lift.
But I need to heal Shayna.
This is the medical room.
Let's see if we can
heal
her. You
are in critical condition. You will need a med pack to be stabilized.
And yeah. Hopefully, this one here. It is.
You have found med packs.
Yep. So now I can.
The med pack can stabilize your condition.
Mm-hmm.
Success. You are stabilized. Mm-hmm. To recover fully, you will require the medical facilities at the Peragus mining station. But you are not in any danger of dying from your wounds right now.
Alright, so T3 saved Shayna. But we need to have, I guess, both of us outside.
This is the main hold.
So the whole maneuver was a bit useless for now. Right. Alright. But it's nice to get to test it, I guess. So, now we both can go
this
outside.
Is a util- you can use this lift
yep.
to take you to the outside of the Ebon Hawk.
That's the plan. Outside. Look at that. Wow. Let's see what we can do. We should.
This is the starboard side of the Ebon
Hawk. Parts?
This open hatch has some parts that will be useful
yep.
for getting main power restored.
Engine port.
This busted engine port has some needed parts for the Ebon Hawk's hyperdrive.
Yep.
Take the parts here back down below to get main power restored.
Okay.
Don't forget to explore the other side of the Ebon Hawk.
This is
the,
bubbles
ahead indicate mines that you've detected automatically.
Right.
Approach mines, recovering mines.
So let's see if we can recover them. No, that's not. That's disabling them. Let's try recover. Right. Too bad I thought too fast on the other one. Right.
You can use the explosive device in this missile to blow open the engine room door inside the Ebon Hawk.
Okay.
This will give you access to the hyperdrive. After you plant a mine, back away quickly so that you do not take damage.
Right. Her voice is very familiar to me. Don't know who she is, but... So that's... yes. I think we're done here. Right.
You can use this lift to take you back inside the Ebon Hawk.
Yep. Go inside. So now, we go... Is it the engine room I wanna blow up?
This is the engine room.
Yes, I think we need to do that. Alright, come here, silly. Are you okay?
This is the engine room.
Port engine?
The port engine is shut down,
right,
but appears intact. Fixing the hyperdrive will allow you to restore power. The hyperdrive is suffering badly. You won't be able to, however, you should be able to rig the hyperdrive.
Yep. Rig the hyperdrive.
Success! The hyperdrive is online. Primary power is restored. Only one step remains. Return to the galaxy map in the cockpit and travel to Peragus.
Alright. C3, I think we're doing a good thing here. Yep. Are you coming? Well...
This is the cockpit.
Yes, I know.
You can now plot a course to the Peragus mining station. To dock with Peragus, left-click on the Peragus planet to select it.
Yep. So, it's an empty map. That's, sad, isn't it? Right. Here we go.
The sensors show the door to the storage compartment is being sliced. There is someone, or something, else alive on the Ebon Hawk.
Didn't shoot T3, please. Say you didn't. And here we are in the KoTOR tank. Yeah. So even the floor knows I'm here. And who are those guys? They look like they are some kind of workers. But yeah, now we're here. And so welcome to Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic 2, or better known as the Sith Lords. Yeah, I modded it a bits to make it as pretty as I could, and that includes a head that's not in the game, in the base game. Yeah, I've modded a mod, so to speak. Well, actually, that's the truth. I modded a couple of mods, to be exact, and so I sort of merged them and changed up her colors to be what she is now. So, any more introduction isn't needed, since we already spoke, or I spoke before we started, so I just wanted to show off her, or Shayna. And yeah, we're not that fully dressed yet, I hope. We're not gonna run around like this for long. It can get chilly, you know? So, Mordor, and medical bay container. Let's just loot everything we find. Med pack, yes please. And then lab station. I don't think we can do much with this at the moment. No. But let's check out the computer. Yeah.
Still examining the survivors of the damaged freighter. Looks like it goes by the name of the Ebon Hawk. Only one survivor, placed in the KoTOR tank for recovery. The carbon scoring on the vessel suggests it was in a battle, but no indication of who fired on it. Couldn't get much from the Nava computer. I'm surprised the ship was able to make it inside the Peragus asteroid field without the asteroid drift charts. Aside from the lone survivor, we recovered an old woman. No life signs. There was also a protocol droid and a utility droid on board. Sent both down to maintenance while security sorts through the other items on the ship. It looks like the utility droid, a T3 unit, was able to get the ship working enough to get to the colony. We're prepared to...
Yeah. Don't stop now. So, this is the history of how they found us. Or the Ebon Hawk for now, at least. So let's see. This was 3 days ago. So let's see what it said 2 days ago then.
Could be a Jedi, but we won't know for sure until we get the transmission back from the Republic. If the survivor is a Jedi, that would account for the recovery rate. But I'm more concerned that a Jedi here may cause trouble. Some of the miners, especially KoTOR, are already another accident today. A detonation in the ventilation tunnels. If the lockdown measures hadn't activated, the whole facility would have been destroyed. Got most of the injured to the KoTOR tanks in time, but the rest had to go to the morgue. One of the wounded said a droid caused the accident, but we couldn't get any specifics.
Yeah, I think I know it was droid. I think we saw him. And what happened one day ago?
Miners about the Jedi. A number of the droids have been acting oddly. And not even memory wipes seem to be fixing the problem. There was a detonation in another one of the fuel vents the droids were working in. We deactivated several of them, and moved them down to maintenance. But we're still treating the plasma burns. That cuts us down to almost half shifts, and with the droids malfunctioning, we may not make the Telos shipment for this month. Fortunately, the detonation didn't cause a lockdown.
Warning! There has been a fuel detonation in the mining tunnels. Emergency lockdown commencing. All personnel report to quarters and prepare for emergency venting countermeasures.
No! If the ventilation systems are malfunctioning, evacuate the medical bay! Everyone evacuate!
Oh. So, they're dead? All of the guys in the KoTOR tanks? Is that it? Damn, there's been a lot of things going on here, and not just with us and the Ebon Hawk. Let's see what's under medical bay functions. We've got... This is the morgue. Right? we can unlock the door. So let's do that. And then unlock medical storage room. Right. I think that's it for now. Yeah. So, don't know why I would want to walk into the morgue, but you know, there's probably a reason to do that. So, the main mystery now is actually, who am I? That's the question, right? And what happened to us? How did Ebon Hawk end up like it did? And why? Why was I there? Why was she there? I don't know. Where's Revan? Where's everyone that traveled with Revan? None of them were on the ship as far as I could tell. So that's the mystery here. Yeah. Alright. So let's go check. Yeah, let's just check the corpses, right?
Find what you're looking for amongst the dead.
Your voice. I heard it as I floated in the KoTOR tank.
Yes, I had hoped as much. I slept here too long and could not awaken. It may be I reached out unconsciously, and your mind must have been a willing one. Or perhaps you have been trained for such things.
So, you can touch minds and feign death? Who are you?
I am Kreia, and I am your rescuer, as you are mine. Tell me, do you recall what happened?
No. Last thing I remember, I was on board a Republic ship. The Harbinger? What happened to it?
Your ship was attacked. You were the only survivor. A result of your Jedi training, no doubt.
So how do you know I was a Jedi?
Your stance, your walk, tells me you are a Jedi. Your walk is heavy. You carry something that weighs you down.
The Jedi Order and I have a troubled history.
So it would seem. Keep your past and let us focus on the now.
All right. What's going on? How did we get here?
I do not know. I was removed from the events of the world as I slept. A survey of the surroundings may provide the answers we seek.
The ship we arrived in, the Ebon Hawk, must still be in this place. We should recover it and leave.
Yeah, I was thinking that too. But why are you in such a hurry?
We were attacked once, and I fear our attackers will not give up the hunt so easily. Without transport, weapons, and information, they will find us easy prey indeed.
You seem nervous, worried. Is something wrong?
Even as I slept, I felt much unrest here. I saw strange visions, minds colored with fear. Now, everything here feels terribly silent. A last word of caution. I would find out as much as you can about this place quickly. I fear we will need to depart as suddenly as we arrived.
We'll see. There's got to be someone left alive around here.
You may wish to extend your search to some clothes, if only for proper first impressions.
Yeah. Agreed. So, are you well enough to travel?
I'm not offering to help you.
Oh.
I'm not so young as to leap from death's door as quickly as you.
Well, I'll return soon to make sure you're all right then.
I leave you to the explorations of this place. Here, I will remain and attempt to center myself.
All right. You'll center yourself in this place. I don't know if I would have chosen a morgue, but so we got a torch of some sort, plasma torch. Yeah. And this is nice. We can switch weapons. I love that. So useful.
Emergency lockdown overridden.
And we got a vibro cutter too. So that means we can have a weapon in the other hand. No, not in the other hand. Another set of weapons. Right, these are for droids. Let's just quickly, yeah, feel a bit naked. I do. Hello. Okay, that wasn't so bad. Mining laser. I think I'm good with the sword. So every droid on this facility is going away or something. Looks like it. So yeah. Seems like someone did that on purpose. Shouldn't be anything in the system to just attack everything. Oh wait, that might be it actually. Yeah. So there were people alive here one day ago, wasn't it? So that's interesting. Alright, at least we got a couple of items. And those broken items, I think we can use them on the workbench and stuff. So, let's see what's here.
Is this thing on? Alright, all hands, especially you, KoTOR, listen up because I'm not going to say this again. The next one of you Juma heads to try and smuggle a blaster, or so help me, any sort of military-grade frag weapons into my facility is gonna take a long walk out the airlock. Why? Because in case you forgot, Peragian fuel explodes at high temperatures. That's what blasted that chunk out of Peragus 2 and created this asteroid field. So if I catch any of you with anything other than sonic charges or mining lasers, I'll burn you and your contract. Security out.
Ah, interesting. Yeah, that would be a problem, wouldn't it? So, let's see. We've got accident report logs.
And according to one of the miners, it was because one of the sonic charges went off prematurely. And like before, it was one set by a mining droid. The three idiots were grouped so close to the charge, it might as well have been a grenade going off. The blast turned their bones to dust. The blast wrecked the internal components of the droid that set the charge, though, so we can't even dissect it to see what happened. I don't like what's going on here. Ever since that Jedi showed up, things are getting worse. It's not just KoTOR and his miners, or the fights, but now the droids are acting crazy. If we don't find what's causing this, or who, this facility's gonna be space dust by the time the next Telos freighter arrives.
Alright, there's a lot of stuff going on here. Let's see. Mining droid maintenance logs.
So, you're in maintenance. Then maybe you can tell me what's going on with these droids.
Sir, I don't know. It's like their behavior cores are undergoing binary decay, but I can't find the source. This shouldn't be happening.
Well, that's reassuring. It isn't happening. So the next time we nearly have a breach in the ventilation tunnels, I could just close my eyes and pretend it's my imagination. You better give me some answers. I want to know the damage these droids can do if they start mining us instead of asteroid rock.
Sir, these droids aren't combat models. Their mining lasers are weaker and less accurate than blasters. I doubt those droids could even hit one of us.
Are you blind? What about the miners in Medbay? It's sabotage, and it started right after the commander said we weren't going to sell the Jedi to the Exchange. So
oh,
I
really?
Want you to find out how these droids are being sabotaged. That'll tell me who's trying to clear a path to get that Jedi off the facility and stop him. In the meantime, make sure the security's armed with all the ion and sonic charges you can find. If those droids start coming after me, I'm gonna need more than low-grade mining lasers to take them down. Clear?
Yes, sir. Maintenance control out.
Idiot.
So, yeah, he's not a people person.
I installed an override switch to shut down any droids on this level, just in case someone locks me out of the administration console. As added insurance, I tied the override switch into the circuit to the holding cell door. It'll make sure it can only be opened if all droids in the level are shut down. I doubt KoTOR or any of his men have the skill to pull off something like this, but I'm not taking any chances while we're sitting in the middle of this asteroid minefield. Whoever's responsible won't be able to have the droids rescue him after I lock him up. Nothing will cut through that door. He'll be trapped.
Okay, I think we got them all. So, what else is here? Yep, that's us. Then... Oh, hello. Yep, more of those droids. They look like spiders. Yeah. So, what else? Another room? No, that's the wrong. Ah, yeah, that's where we need to go. And the holding cells? Hello! It's a person? A live person. What else? Right. So, I think that's it. Yeah. Okay, so we know there's another person alive. At least one.
Be careful. There is much energy in the room beyond.
Freya?
Yet it stems from nothing that lives.
What?
Can you not sense them? Reach out. Cast aside your sight. Cast aside what you see. And instead, reach out with your perception. Ah, you can feel them. The droids you cannot perceive, but the small oscillations of energy, that you can feel, echoing outwards.
So, with Kreia's help, you have gained the passive precognition power. When this power is triggered, you should save your game. Uh-huh. So I guess we save our game. And that's going to be my first save, and I also feel like it's a good spot to wrap up this episode. Just call it, yeah, let's call it. That's easy enough to remember. Right, so we are exploring Peragus. And we're going to continue doing that in the next episode. So I hope you enjoy this. I have. And I know I'm going to continue to enjoy this. Thanks for watching. Bye.